Hello, malty marzipans. And thank you to Broth UHV84 for that malt mention. Introducing Whisky Review 395. Having just concluded a series of reviews on quality American bourbons and whiskies, I'm now going to round the circle, so to speak, by mentioning a spirit which is absolutely synonymous with the United States of America, and in particular Canada. Rye whiskey. Have you ever tried rye whiskey? What you do, you go to your local grocer or supermarket and you buy some rye bread, and that will give you an introduction to the flavour of rye if you've never tasted it out the bottle. When you taste it, you will find it utterly distinctive. There's no mistaking it. Rye is arguably the most fully flavoured and intensely flavoured of all the cultivated grains used for the production of whisky. Got one here, a straight rye, bottled in Kentucky, and it's called Pikesville. Rye's a bit like bourbon. Under American regulations, it must be a minimum of 51% rye grain. The remaining 49% can be other grains to kind of balance things off and round things off and basically pep up the mash bill. However, rye whiskey, even at 51%, is such an intensely flavoured grain. There's no mistaking it. There's nothing vague about rye whiskey. Very popular in the United States prior to Prohibition, but as part of the bar and shebeen culture of cocktails and sweet drinks that dominated the Prohibition years, it kind of fell out of favour, rye. It was seen as simply too rough, too intensely flavoured. And in fact, one of the old American ways of drinking rye was a whiskey and rye. In other words, you'd get a kind of rougher barley whiskey, and you'd add a touch of more intensely flavoured rye to mask the rough edges of young whiskey or bourbon. So it's all about flavour, and a very distinctive flavour as well. So let me see now. Bottled at 40%, this one. Available East Coast of America and Europe, mainly in Britain actually, becoming quite popular in Britain, not just as a mixing rye, but as drinking on its own straight, and I'm going to tell you why that is. The nose is really quite aromatic. It's got that kind of bright spiciness. Now, when it comes to American ryes, there's kind of two distinct styles. There's the Pennsylvanian style, which is quite spicy, and there's the Maryland style, which is more fruity. And they achieve the different styles simply through the different process of preparing the rye and the different style of distillation. In fact, it's basically a sum total of just the way they produce the spirit. Different yeast varieties certainly make a difference, and different rye varieties, because we tend to view it as one particular type of grain, but in fact rye is quite a large variety of different types of grain. You get your soft rye, you get your intense rye, you get your summer rye, winter rye, all sorts of ryes. The nose. Aromatic, spicy fresh fruit, cough sweets. Quite syrupy, phenolic. Camphor, spearmint, cherry, papaya, banana, ginger, cinnamon, cinnamon buns, Cinnabon, you would call it in America. You know, the real high calorie stuff. There's nothing subtle about this. This really is pretty full on. And I don't know if any of you use these special rub-in creams when you get sports injuries. Sometimes it's called All Bass Oil. Sometimes it's called Tiger Rub. But there's quite a bit of that in, you know, could be associated with rye, this particular rye. It's a relatively young spirit, this one. But it's cleanly made. It's actually well made. So what you'll notice, the smell is all up front. It isn't kind of hugely complex in the development. But in terms of the volume of arrival, it's certainly quite a busy whiskey. In terms of adding water, I would actually watch what you add. You'd imagine that being a strong flavoured spirit, it would need a lot of water, but it's not the case. Half a teaspoon, that'll do. Oh, aye. Intense, concentrated fruit cordials, rich sweet red fruits, strawberry, raspberry, cranberry. There's a bitterness in there too, woodworm bitterness, mint, definitely vanilla, honey, muscovado sugar. Cardamom, so we're getting quite intense spicy notes, cumin even, cinnamon, raspberry jam, getting raspberry jam. I do recommend, by the way, that as a young spirit, this really is so intense that you really want to let it settle down in the glass a bit, otherwise it's going to be quite an aggressive experience. Toning down already. And the finish, you're getting a touch of tannin and savoury note, savoury cereal, slight burnt cereal note, honey, rye grain, vanilla, wood dust, and it's a relatively short finish, as one would expect from a relatively young spirit. The real highlight of Pikesville is the fact that it gives a big full-on, decent rye arrival. Certainly in Britain, a very accessible price in terms of ryes. There's not such a huge variety of rye whiskies to choose from. Probably I would start with the likes of Alberta Premium from Canada, which is a very measured, composed rye whiskey. This is really the opposite. This is almost, you know, the grain, the intense rye grain, has really been left to get on with it, but has delivered something that's rich, punchy, fruity. In fact, for me, it's reminiscent of Ray and Nephew overproof Jamaican rum. Not quite sure why, but I think it's something to do with the aldehyde content. Anyway, 85 out of 100. Yep, it's a decent old rye mark. And before you buy a bottle, if you've never tasted it before, it's going to be a lot cheaper for you to buy some rye bread, very popular in Germany and very nutritious for you. It's good for you. But if you smell this and taste it, it will get you into the kind of frame of mind and into the right area as to know what to expect if you were to buy a bottle. With this rye, you're either going to love it or you're going to hate it. Personally, I'm enjoying it, but only in small doses. I wouldn't want to be dependent on rye all the time. Simple as that. So, I hope you found this a useful introduction. This is really the first rye whiskey that I've reviewed here at Ralphie.com, but certainly not the last. Judging by the two bottles up on the shelf, yes, it's a hat trick, a rye hat trick. Three reviews, one after the other, all about rye. We'll see you shortly for the next review, in which we'll be tackling a 25-year-old Rittenhouse rye from Heaven Hill Distillery. See you soon. Bye-bye.